You are going for your first date. Why would you not choose Jala? Pick up a Monday or pick up a Friday for a date. You don't want to pick up a Tuesday for your first date because it's more of Agni. You want more of Jala, right? You are going to meet there not to fight, but sort of to build up a relationship, to see whether, you know, you can break the ice, whether you can connect. In olden days, everybody knew this. Unfortunately, with the advent of Kali Yuga, a lot of people feel this is a rocket science. Whereas in olden days, everybody knew Panchanga. Nobody called up an astrologer or a Panditji to find out when the Ekadashi is.
Hello and Namaste, and thank you so much for visiting my channel. My name is Karthik Gaur, and please do subscribe and click the bell icon to ensure that whenever we upload a webinar or a video, you are the first ones to know. Thank you so much.
We are going to understand a little bit about the Vara. Vara, as I told you, is associated with a word, or it comes from a word called as Vasara. Okay, and Vasara is again a sort of a combination of two words. Vasa basically means to leave, and Ra is again a Agni Bija. Hence, the whole concept of Vara is associated with the ability of Agni to stay in your body, whether you have that Agni. You know, there are certain people, when they walk and come to you, they feel that, oh my goodness, you know, he will fall down before he reaches. And then there are certain people, you know, who have a walk, you know, like a very, very awesome walk, very, very purposeful walk, you know, very, very straight, shoulders not drooping, you know, not hunchback, you know, very, very confident, very purposeful. You know, that energy is very different. You know, immediately you see them, you want to do business with them, you want to deal with them, you like their energy, you want to be associated with them. You feel that whenever you talk to them, you know, in a way, you know, they imbibe a certain level of energy into you. They give you hope. Sometimes the reverse happens. You meet certain people, they are always crying, their energy is always low. You know, they have slept for 12 hours and waken up, but when you see them, you feel that, you know, they are so delicate, they will almost fall down. You know, somehow, you know, we don't like that energy. Hence, the Vara becomes very important. And the day lord, or the day on which you are born, becomes so, so very important. Okay? Vara can be ruled by technically seven planets. Okay? Which is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Lot of times students have asked, you know, hey, Karthik, there are Navagrahas. Why not Rahu and Ketu? The answer is that Vara is all about your energy. And for energy, you can't have Grahas which are not Purna Grahas. Or shall we say the Grahas who don't have full body. Yeah. As most of you know, or all of you know, Rahu and Ketu don't have the full body. Ketu doesn't have the top part, yeah, and the Rahu doesn't have the bottom part, right? Hence, as a result of which, Ketu doesn't have a Graha Drishti. Why? Because Ketu has got no eyes. The top part is missing. Okay, so very important. So that is the reason why Rahu and Ketu are not considered in the Vara scheme, or they are not given the special days for them. However, you can always say that Ketu is like Mars because they are the co-lord of Scorpio. Hence, you can use Tuesday for Ketu, which is Ganesha Puja, and you can use Saturday for Rahu. So it can be for Badaka Puja, or for example, you can also do Durga Puja also on specific Saturdays. Okay. So very, very important. Okay. So those are important. Now, here comes a big problem. Sometimes people don't know which Varesh to take. Okay. For example, in my case, I'm somebody who is born, let's say, at 5:40 a.m. in the morning. Okay. But on that particular day, you know, the sunrise was, let's say, at 6:15 a.m. So what do I do? Do I take the English concept of a day which is changing after 12 o'clock midnight, or is there any clear rules given in the Vedic scriptures? The answer is that the Vedic scriptures have got clear meaning, and they have given clear understanding that, hey, Agni or the sunrise or Surya is going to be denoting the mark of the day. Or Surya, which is the rising point, is something which has to be taken as the start of the day, and that is how we judge it. So let's say if I am born on a 5:40 a.m., then I need to take myself as born on a previous day rather than the day in which I was born. Okay, so this is something which I wanted to raise very, very importantly. Okay, generally we can say 6 a.m. as the sunrise time. Okay, and that is associated with the Mahakal Hora. We'll be studying that also today. Okay, but generally, let's say in places where they might say that we are having a sort of a different climate, or the sunrise, you know, we can't see visibly on the sun because during winter we have this or that, or various very cold regions, you know, then generally you take it as 6 a.m. is the sunrise. Okay, so that is also a workaround which is there. But areas where there is clear sunrise and clear sunset, you should always look at the Panchanga for the day to announce what is the Varesh. Okay, sometimes even for naming of child, etc., those things become very, very important. Okay, now, what are the Vedic weekdays? Now, this is how you learn. You know, when you are growing up as a Jyotishi, when you are learning it as a from scratch, then this is how you have to learn. Okay, Sun is also called Ravi, and Sunday is also called as Surya Vasara, Ravi Vara. You know, so this concept of Vara is all about the day, or the one that is the energy that is going to stay in that day. So on a Sunday, Surya's energy is going to stay for the day. On Monday, Somavara, the concept of Chandra or Soma is something that's going to stay there. On Mangal, you know, which is Mars, or Mangalavasara, you know, then the energy of Mars is going to stay. Likewise for Mercury, which is Budhavara. Jupiter is Guruvara. Shukra is Shukravara. Shani is Shanivara. So these Saptagrahas are special grahas which are having a Vedic day named after them. Okay? Now, a lot of people feel that, hey, the order of the day will be very random, or was there a lucky draw which Brahma did, or which the Rishis did? You know, why is the order of the day like this? The answer is, it is purely having a logic to it, and the logic is in understanding the Hora. So from Hora, technically we get the concept of Vara. Hence the Hora is of prime importance every day. Why? Because from Hora has come the Vara. So every hour of the day has got a separate Hora. Most of you might be aware of it. If not, then welcome. You know, at least today you have learnt it. So there are 24 Horas in a day, and 24 hours are denoted by separate planets. Depending on which, you can pick up the activity and start doing things. Okay? So this is something which is very important. Can we derive it? Yes, we are going to derive it today. In fact, all of you are going to derive it today. Okay? Note well, the weekdays and horas are connected via Agni. Okay? So it is very important. It is all like a triangle which is happening. You know, Hora, weekday and Agni, you know. So Agni is like that common thread, because the Vara, Agni is the carrier in the Vara. And likewise, the Hora is creating the Vara. So they all are directly connected with the Agni. hence an ability to do in a particular day. In which direction in that day is the Agni flowing? What is the good activity to be done on that particular day is seen from Vara. You want to sue somebody, you want to put a legal case on somebody. Hey, pick up a Tuesday. The Vara is of Mangal. It is fighting. But if you want to go for a compromise, you know, you are going for your first date, why would you not choose Jala? Pick up a Monday or pick up a Friday for a date. Right? You don't want to pick up a Tuesday for your first date. Yeah? Because it's more of Agni. You want more of Jala, right? You are going to meet there not to fight, but sort of to build up a relationship, to see whether, you know, you can break the ice, whether you can connect. So these are all smaller things which you have to take care of. In olden days, everybody knew this. Unfortunately, with the advent of Kali Yuga, a lot of people feel this is a rocket science. Whereas in olden days, everybody knew Panchanga. Nobody called up an astrologer or a Panditji to find out when the Ekadashi is. Unfortunately, in today's time, people do call up. Right? Or sometimes they just do a Google search. But what I mean to say, the weekday is very important. And the Murata is very important for specific activities. These all things in the end, I'm going to do a lot of those activities, you know, and I'm going to help you to get a clarity on this. Okay. But understand that it is the energy part of it. And understand which things need energy. Okay. So let's say, what do you need energy for? Okay. So it could be, let's say, going to the gym or starting a gym membership. So if you have to start a gym membership and, you know, ensure or go to a gym every day, you know, can you pick up that particular vara or that particular hora or that particular time of the day based on which a particular planet is strong? You want to do bodybuilding, you want to build up muscles, etc., you know, then Mangal would be a very good thing to do. You want to do all about flexibility, all about yoga, then technically Mercury would be very good, or the Sandhya periods, which would be very good. You know, 5 a.m. or 5 p.m., 6 p.m., you know, those ranges are very good for cardio things. Okay, so these all things are very, very important for us to understand. Now, these are certain rules of Panchanga, which I have listed out. Okay. Varesh is of prime importance, and a negative lord can show ill health or ill energy. So generally, you want your Varesh to be very strong to ensure your energy levels are always high. You know, even at 12 o'clock in midnight, you know, if somebody tells you to do something, you know, you are always ready. Okay? Now, these are some basic rules. You know, malefic planets afflicting Varesha is not good. So generally, we want benefic planets associated with Varesha and Varesha to be a benefic planet. You know, the second is, malefic Varesha can show low energy and also ill health. Okay? So because your energy levels are low, your shoulders are drooping, you aren't able to work more than 4 hours, you know, then technically you have a malefic Varesha, and that you, the placement can be very bad as well. Yeah. The third is weak Surya. Surya ultimately is the carrier of energy. So in fact, I would say Surya and Mangala, both are Agni Tattva. So that, to that extent, it is very important to see the energy. Okay. Malefic planets afflicting Shanavaresh. What is Shanavaresh? It is nothing but your Hora Lord. So a lot of you who are absolutely new, you will understand everything. Okay, don't worry. You know, step by step, as I said, Rome was not built in a day. So don't get too sort of worked up that I don't know this, I don't know that. You don't know it. That is precisely the reason you are studying with me. Right? So calm down and understand that Shanavaresh is something, the Hora in which you are born, or hora of a particular day. For example, I always like to start at 8 p.m. in my local time. Why do I start at 8 p.m.? Because the hora of that day is starting at 8:01 or 8 p.m. Right? But on the first day, I did it a little early because that was just to ensure that the Muhurta is correct. So that's a different concept. Okay? So what we are now understanding is that there is called a Shanavaresh, which is all about your Hora Lord. And if that is a malefic planet, then it can also show very poor energy. Specifically can show that, you know, you are not using your energy wisely. You know, it's like, you know, if cleaning this bulb is going to take me 3 hours, and let's say there is a cleaning service which is going to charge me $10 to clean it, why would I spend my 3 hours using and doing that? You know, which we call it as optimum utilization of your resources or using strategic time, right? Or doing what is your core domain. You know, cleaning is not your core domain. Or let's say editing a video is not my core domain. Why would I sort of spend 3 hours a day, 4 hours a day doing that? You understand? So very important to understand that the Shanavaresh is very important. And if that is also not having a sort of a right sort of a combination, then it technically shows that you are using your energy into very useless purposes. Also, if, you know, body can be a little weak, you know, if there is a weak Mars, you know, where you are feeling, you know, sometimes people have that this weak fingers, you know, it is nothing major, but it is just that, let's say, if they need to play a racket sport, you know, they aren't able to probably hit the ball very hard or able to hit the shuttle very hard if they are playing, let's say, badminton, because generally their fingers are very weak. They aren't able to grip the racket. Okay, that's where we need to remedy these things. Okay, now, an ill-placed and a weak Varesh or Hora Lord can show a weak digestive constitution. Okay, very important, you know, because it is fifth house. Fifth house is Leo. Think like an astrologer now. Most of you have gone through that grind a little bit. You know, digestion, you know, is all about your fifth house and sixth house, right? It's Leo. Digestion of knowledge is all about Leo. And here we are talking about Vara, which is all about your Agni. So if you have it weak, then the Naisargika Karaka, or that natural ability of a Vara, is also diminished. Your metabolism is slow, you know, you aren't able to digest well. You know, somewhere down the line, you always feel bloated, you always feel heavy, as a result of which you aren't able to sort of digest well. Okay? Also weak liver, etc. This is very important. Especially, you know, I'm going to talk about a lot of cases, you know, on this liver issues, etc. And simple rules by which I'll show you what's happening in the life. Okay? And the fifth house is also Leo, which I just talked about. And that is the seat of Agni. You know, you also know that the exaltation is happening in Aries, which is again an Agni sign and a royal sign. Okay? And that is very important. The seventh house, or generally Libra, is also called as Asta Lagna. By now you all know. And hence the seventh house from the Agni is something, you know, which is using the Agni the most. Or ultimately, that is where finally the Agni will get over or diminished. So always look forward to where your Varesh and your Shanavaresh is there. Currently, let us just talk about your Varesh. And look at the seventh therefrom as well. So seventh therefrom can be a place where a lot of your activity or a lot of your sort of work is happening. As a result of which, finally the Agni is being diminished. Okay, so very important. Now, few of the pointers is that the Badaka house is its eclipse. So you don't want your Varesh to be in a Badaka house. Okay, we'll be doing Badaka later on. But what I mean to say is that it is a house, you know, which can actually be the worst house for the Varesh to be. Okay, and Badakesh means the lord of your Badaka. For example, if I'm Aries ascendant, then Rahu and Saturn both become my Badakesh. But Badakesh is the root cause of the obstruction, unless planets are in Badaka house that cause it to be blocked. Okay, so these all things are a little sort of an advanced thing, but nonetheless, when we do Badaka, or let's say when we do the example charts, I'll make it simpler for you and I'll make you understand. Currently, when it comes to just the theory part, it might be a little bit problematic. But what I mean to say is that whenever Badaka and the Varesha also have a combination or are having a sort of a yoga to that level, you know, the energy levels might be dropping, or there is a certain amount of eclipse, you know, which a person goes through. Okay, and this all we are talking in terms of the energy. Okay, so don't confuse a Varesh to your finances or a Varesh to your relationship. Okay, Varachakra is also regularly ordered from the weekday, starting from Sunday. Now, this is one thing which I always wanted to tell you. You should have your calendar or even your Microsoft calendar always start from Sunday. Now, most of you have seen they start their calendars from Monday or Saturday or Thursday. I don't know different types of day. But technically speaking, Surya is the Vara Lord. So your calendar technically should be starting from a Sunday. Agreed? So, and it is very simple. You know, you just have to do the settings and let it start from Sunday. Technically, 6 a.m. should be the start of your day. So in your calendar, you know, from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m., 8 p.m., whatever time you want to keep, is the time when which should be your productive time. And you should be accountable and you should hold yourself accountable to those times. Okay? So I think you sort of got the first part of the rules. The other results, you know, which is associated with Varesh. When you have a strong Varesh, it is very good for your energy as well as now we are talking about your wealth and career. Why? Because inherently, you know, it has got that association with your career. Let's say if you have an energy, let's say if you have more energy, let's say you have a positive energy, then definitely to that level, you have an ability to do more work. You have an ability to do more productive. You know, if you're more productive, then definitely it impacts your career and your wealth as well. Okay. Affliction to Varesha causes loss of health. Okay. Why? Again, they are all energy related things. You know, why? Because, you know, your energy is low. So if your energy is low, then technically you have been too lazy. You know, you haven't been going to the gym. You don't walk. Your vitals then become very bad, and that impacts your health. You know, body disorders can be obesity at a very basic level, but there are a lot of other things that can happen at a very, very different level. Okay, and if there is an affliction, okay, let's say your Varesha is a positive planet and let's say it is with Rahu or Saturn, then during those periods or those dashas, technically you go through a lot of fluctuations in health also. Okay, when it is in Dushtana is technically 6, 8 and 12 in strict terms, you know, though people consider the third house also as part of it, but third house is sort of a neutral house. Okay, so when your Varesha is in Dushtana, then to that level, when your Varesha has been in Dushtana, it technically shows you a lot of trouble coming because of enmity. It can also happen that a lot of bad people or a lot of evil eye or when we understand Badaka, obviously we'll be able to know more. But generally, you know, when it is in a Dushtana, 6, 8 and 12, it is not good at all. You know, it is causing a lot of jealousy. It is causing a lot of troubles from people, evil eye, sometimes black magic. You know, those things which are not good at all. Okay. Generally, how do we bifurcate between the Varesha? Is we see the Saumya Grahas, which is Moon, Mercury, Venus and Jupiter. Okay. Are superb. Especially Mercury and Jupiter, if you are born on a Wednesday or a Thursday, it is brilliant. Okay, whereas the Krura planet, which is, you know, Surya, Mangala and Shani, you know, show the possibility of, you know, jisko hum English mein, Hindi mein bolte hai, Abel mujhe mar, you know, they can create troubles for themselves. So if you are born on Sunday, Tuesday or Saturday, then to that level, you have this little bit of problem coming because of Krura Graha. Okay. Always look at the remedies for the Varesh to increase your energy. Okay. Especially, you know, if you are going through that phase where suddenly you are all fine, but suddenly your energies have gone down. You know, you work for 2-3 hours and, you know, you feel drowsy, you want to go to sleep, you know, you just want to, you are binging, you know, on Netflix and, you know, you are just sitting and become a couch potato. You know, if there is a disorder in your life which is happening because of low energy, then definitely Varesh is something that needs to be seen. Okay, and that is something which has to be seen.
Namaste Jyotisha lovers, thank you so much for viewing the video. Please do share so more and more thirsty souls can benefit from this free knowledge which is being shared. Also, do subscribe, click the bell icon, and all the questions that you have, please mention in the comment section below. Thank you so much, and please keep supporting us.